we formed this band. We made a record before we had it, and we're making the record in 2008. And over the course of that year and that summer, especially, there was a lot of television coverage of the presidential campaign, and that just happened to be a word that I noticed was being used like a lot to describe like different stuff would be called a generational issue or something like that, describing like the way certain things might break down along the lines of two different age groups or multiple age groups. So just used it.
And we sometimes discuss like the idea of generational differences, like differences in generations, different attitudes of the Gen X generation.
Right.
It's like a millennial. It's something that is kind of interesting to us, but not really, doesn't have that specific bearing on our how we write music. It's just like a name that we both like enough to make it our name.
I just gone to a record store and I was walking home. I was in the middle of the crossfire of a drive-by shooting and it's caught the bullet. You know, the doctors, when I got to the hospital, they pulled the record out. It was in my chest and they pulled out and had like the imprint of the bullet in it. They're like, if you had brought this record, you'd be dead. It was Fat Boys? Fat Boys, second album, Back and Fatter.
By other members of the band?
I don't think this band has a lot of intra-band sex that I'm aware of. Are you aware of that?
I'd just rather not say for now. For fear of just blowing anybody up.
Are they French?
Yeah, there's some guys on the DL. You know what I mean? You have a brother that has
the quality.
I like sour candy. And I like yellow Gatorade.
What do you want, Gatorade? We're getting like smart food, the popcorn. You know what I'm talking about. It's like, it comes in a black bag.
Oh, yeah.
It's got like, kind of tastes like popcorn, like cheesy, smart food popcorn. And I've also been just getting into like regular, original M&Ms.
I hesitate to bring it up. We went through a period where we were getting second degree burn Doritos. There's a special Dorito that came out. One was first degree burns, which is first and second.
It's first and second, and there's chemical burns. I think Doritos are just trying to constantly one-up themselves over the most ferociously, you know,
spicy,
toxic, spicy chips they can make. So we ended up, we kind of went with them on that journey, and it turned out to be not a good idea. Like, some of the chips, especially second degree burns, got to be to the point where it was like sheerly for sport. They didn't even taste good at that point, and they would just like, it would come back upon you, you know what I mean? Like, you don't want to ingest the bag of that. Just to get it on your hands, I feel like was playing with fire.
We have a lot of Doritos brand loyalty, but that was really, they're pushing it.
We're willing to take that journey with them, but I feel like they were testing us, almost like to see how far people.
I don't know, that's something I think about a lot, I guess, you know? When it comes to being in a band, making music, I think making something that you really, really like is really different. Because having other people like it is ultimately out of your control, but, you know, it's making something that really makes you happy and that you're proud of and successful. Is that audio picking up there?
Yes!
Eyes crack bullshit?
Yeah, don't
keep pushing me.
Shut the fuck up! I'm trying to tape something.
Shooter. Who calls that Shooter? Is that like a Yankee that said that? It'd be called... the four men and a baby, because one of the members of the band is a fucking baby, emotionally.
Yeah, that's good.
And the way the shot goes is, you pour some baby formula into a shot glass, and then some, like, roofies, and then you drink that.